Alright, so right there it is. That's the movie in the background. With everything going on. Campsite.
Hey, this is Coach Bill 315, and about to hit the trail. I'm on the dirt road right now. I'm gonna be arriving at Patterson Gap in a couple moments. I'm with a meetup group, and we're gonna be hiking and do some good mileage this weekend. Now there's supposed to be a 50-year storm coming, and you know, we're prepared for it. And I got my nice little passenger over here. Say hi. Hi, fans. That's my passenger right there. That's the Z-Pack Art Blast Cuban Fiber Backpack. It weighs about 21 ounces. I'll do a review a little bit later. But this trail that we're going on is the trail that I got lost maybe like 3 weeks ago. So it's going to be interesting seeing the trail again. And I'm definitely going to be paying a little bit more attention to this trail, because it is kind of like overgrown. There's a lot of brush. It's September 9th, and we got this hurricane coming up the coast right now. Irmas. So don't let Irmas get the better of your mass. With that said, I'll see you guys out on the trail, and balls con dias, bruh. If you want to check out that 360 video of the shelter, the link will be right up here. It's a pretty cool shelter. So if you want to take a look at that, I went ahead and made it into a time lapse. So you can kind of see like what we do on our breaks and get a 360 view of what a car gap shelter looks like. I'm in the back right now, just filming a little of everything. And we got about 6 more miles to Elbert Mountain, and I'll give you some footage when we get up there. Over and out. We're at a nice little lookout area, and it looks pretty beautiful out here. Real nice little scenery from walking in the green tunnel. So nice little scenery, and we're continuing walking towards Elbert Mountain, and I mean, great scenery right here. We got a couple pups with us, and the rest of the group is up here. We got a pup and Anna back there, and we're making it. Our target time is about 6 p.m. And why don't we say hi, little pup? Hey, little pup. Just look at this terrain. It's very beautiful. I definitely enjoy it. I don't know if you can see them way back there. I mean, up ahead. But they're cruising. Dimitri, he's leading this group right now. He organizes this meetup trip right here for us. So, special thanks to Dimitri. Thank you for hosting this this meetup group. I'm sure we all enjoy it. And thanks a lot, man. Appreciate it. What's the name of this lookout?
What?
Does anyone know the name of this lookout? Laurel?
I think it just said just
Mountain Laurel.
Oh, Mountain Laurel?
I'm just making that up.
Oh.
We'll go with it.
Oh. Everyone say hi.
Hello.
Hello. We made it to one of the lookouts. And it looks pretty cool. Not gonna lie.
Perfect.
Looks really cool.
Oh, give me a go. That's a good smile.
We all have our phones out. We're all taking videos. We're all taking pictures.
I took 20. Check it out.
Thank you.
No, I don't.
Oh, do I?
Okay,
oh, I have my my camera light on. This hasn't been the first time that Dimitri reminded me of that.
All right, be safe.
All right, Dimitri.
Coach. Oh. All right, guys.
All right, catch you later.
Have fun. Watch out for those bears.
Yep. Bye, Persky.
We'll see you next time.
Yep.
Okay.
Hope to see you all soon.
Right. Bye, yeah, Paul, going back.
All right, catch you later. Dimitri, he's heading back. He just came out to hike with us for a couple hours and a couple miles. Something that came up, so he's heading back to Patterson Gap. But we're still hiking, and it's about 4 o'clock, so we have maybe like 4 more miles left, more or less. And that's
that. 2.5 miles to Albert.
Oh, wait, how many miles?
2.5 to
Albert. 2.5 miles.
To Albert.
That's awesome. Perfect.
And then we're going to walk from Albert to the camp.
And how far is the camp? We're all using a
0.6 miles more.
0.6? Okay.
Half mile.
Wait, from here?
3 miles from here.
Oh,
okay. So one of our friends, Anna, right?
Yep.
Anna says this is the
chicken of the wood.
Chicken of the wood, and this is edible right here.
Uh-huh. Delicious.
And what's the special recipe?
Deep fry, like a chicken. You can do anything like chicken. It is firm, like a chicken meat. Hmm. Yeah, I was looking the
whole
time.
That is cool. All right, this is our water source. Oh, you can actually see all the way through it. It's cool. And every once in a while, this water will come out slowly. And then dumps out like that, some randomly. Why? We do not know why, but it is random. Yeah, but we're all getting water.
Yeah, that
right
is,
now.
That's pretty right there. That's gorgeous. I mean, you can see it for miles out there. Wow. Yeah, that's pretty.
We're making the last push to Elbert Mountain, and it's pretty steep. But this is some of the terrain. It's pretty cool. We're just gonna keep on going up and up. And up. This is no joke. And the sun is shining. But we're almost there. Maybe not. Looks like it keeps on going. But I'll see you guys when we get up there. Hey, yeah, made it up there. Check it out. Pretty sure this is the lookout. What do we got there? Yeah, white blaze. So
great scenery. Can't really beat this right here. Fantastic day, amazing. Sounds like there's some campers up there, which is pretty cool. Gonna go make my appearance and say what up. But this is it. This is it. What's up, Kevin? Yeah, buddy.
Put up a good fight.
Yeah.
We won. Oh, yeah.
It's good, right?
Oh, it's good.
I mean, you can see out forever.
We haven't even made the fire tower yet.
Wait, this isn't it?
No.
This isn't it. Wow.
I think we got a fire tower on up.
Yeah.
This ain't it.
Sweet, man.
This is a good view, though.
Yeah, it is. All right, there's only one thing to do from here, to climb up this thing. So we can take a view at this, at the top is at the highest peak of this mountain right here. Let's see what this little symbol says. Albert, 1969, little survey marker. All right, pretty close to the 100 mile mark on the AT. Gonna climb up here. Oh, they got a maximum capacity level. 14 people. That'd be pretty tough. You going to the top?
Nope, fear of heights. I'm like, that's as far as I can go.
Oh, we got like a little dream catcher up there.
Yeah, one more flight.
Yeah, this is kind of spooky up here.
Yeah, no, I'm like, I can't do it.
Ooh, Kevin, you got to come up here, man.
No, I can't do it, man.
Woo! Yeah, Mike, you coming up here?
Yep.
All right, awesome.
Now, this is the whole reason.
Yeah. Jillian, you coming up?
Yep.
Oh. Whoa.
Fear of heights won't let me go any higher.
I don't know if we can get to the top.
Yeah, you can't.
All right, looks like we can't get to the top. All right, I'm gonna pull out the 360 camera, get a 360 view of this. This is amazing. This is amazing. Whoa, this is so cool. This is cool. Yes, it is. Mike, I'm pretty sure that this must have been open at one point, though. I mean, why would it be closed?
I guess they still use this, right?
I would think so. Yeah, this is pretty cool. All right, let's see how fast a camera can drop. We're up here. This is the fire tower. We were gonna plan on traveling like a half a mile down, but it's just so beautiful up here, and we also want to wake up to a nice sunrise, and we're able to see the sunset too. And having my cup of coffee, we already ate. Mike started a fire, and we got camp all set up, and now we're just filming
soaking in this amazing view up here. It looks like a painting. If you guys want to check out the 360 time lapse, it's being filmed right now. So that might be cool. It's filming everything from when the sun started going down. So it should be pretty cool. I like to check it out myself. So, but this is amazing up here. It is kind of chilly up here. What do you think the temperature is?
I bet it's around 50.
50? And then with that wind breeze. So, we're gonna have some coffee up here. Enjoy the rest of the sunset. If you're enjoying this view, check it out on the 360. Sailors to light.
Yeah, so that's saying be good weather tonight.
Yeah.
Tomorrow.
Wow. Wow. This is something else. Oh, here comes the sun. I see it.
Cause that way's south.
So we're out here at our campsite. We got a movie going on. Using the movie projector right there.
See?
Right there's the rain pair. I'm going to turn off the light so you can actually see what it looks like. Alright, so right there it is. That's the movie in the background. With everything going on. Campsite.
Good morning. It was pretty windy out last night. But we made it. And looks like the sun's coming up, so I'm gonna get out and check out the sunrise at the top of the fire tower. It's about 6:45 right now, but I was definitely toasty in here, but it was very, very windy. So, plus I watched like some scary movie last night, Man versus. That's the name of it, Man Versus. It's like in a scary movie where this guy's out in the woods. Don't watch scary movies like that. Alright, I'm gonna go check out this the sunrise.
Good morning. We're at the top of the fire tower right now. And it is so windy. It is so windy, it's so cold. Taking a time lapse. So that's like right out there on the edge, living on the edge. Yeah. Hello. Hello.
Good morning.
Good morning. But yeah, it's definitely cold out here.
Sleep on me. Feel the rhythm in my chest, just breathe. I will stay, so the lantern in your heart won't fade. The secrets you tell me, I'll take to my grave. There's bones in my closet, but you hang stuff anyway.
And if you have nightmares, we'll dance on the bed. I know that you love me, even when I lose my head. Guillotine. Bum ba dim bum bum doody, bum ba dim bum bum doody. Guillotine. Bum ba dim bum bum, even when I lose my head. Guillotine. Bum ba dim bum bum doody, bum ba dim bum bum doody. Guillotine. That we built won't cave. The secrets you tell me, I'll take to my grave. There's bones in my closet, but you hang stuff anyway. And if you have nightmares, we'll dance on the bed. I know that you love me, even when I lose my head. Guillotine. Guillotine.
Alright, I'm descending Elbert Mountain right now, and another amazing, great look. Wow. Wow. Yeah. Amazing. But it's 8 o'clock right now. It probably got into the 50s. Not too bad. But it's windy up here. I mean, we're on top of a mountain, so. And we're cruising. The 50-year storm didn't hit us. Not yet. But, alright. Later. Hey. Just checking in with you guys. And I just wanted to show you this beautiful campsite up ahead. This is like really nice. I would definitely hike up here and stay up here for a night. For one, check out your view right here. This is nice. You got a couple good camp spots. You got a tree that you can hang from. Let's see, like right here to that one right there. Also some tent spots. And you have your own fireplace. Pretty nice, and you have this amazing lookout view. Wow, let's take a look. Can't even speak right now. Let's take a look at this. Wow. Yeah, this is pretty cool. Definitely worth camping up here. This is nice. This is really nice. I love it. But this is great. This is great. It's been a great weekend for our meetup trip. So once again, I got to give a big thanks to Dimitri. Sorry that you couldn't make it out here for the full night, but we appreciate you taking us up here and hiking with us yesterday. That was great. And I've still been thinking about that movie last night, Man vs. And that is a scary movie. So one of my recommendations is, do not watch a scary movie that is based around in the woods, because when you have the natural sounds going on, and then you have the sounds that are going on throughout the movie, man, you start freaking out. I was freaking out left and right. I would actually play back 30 seconds and see if I could pick up the same sound that I picked up in the movie. Yeah, pretty crazy. It's 9:30. I gotta hustle. I gotta hustle. I'm trying to make it to a coverage gap by 10 o'clock. And I don't even know how far I am away from it right now. I got a book though. I definitely got a book. All right, just another lookout. Wanted to say hi and bye. Out there, let's see if I can find it on here. Nope. Right around here is a table rock from Linville Gorge. I thought it was pretty cool. But hey, we need to hit the trail running right now. It's 9:42. I checked the mileage. I'm about 2 miles out. So I need to pick it up. Definitely need to pick it up. But this trail is pretty nice right now, so I can get some good mileage on his feet. All right, it's 10:11 right now. Just made it to Carter's Gap shelter and heading to Patterson Gap. This is where I got lost last time. But as you can see, there's not really much of a trail. I'll film like where it gets really sticky, so I shouldn't get in any situations where I'm nervous or anything. Knock on wood. All right, over and out until we get to that tricky spot. Okay, thanks. Okay, so right here you can see the path. But if you look up and around, I mean, it's very hard to tell, but it's somewhere in that direction. So when they come down here, they're gonna hopefully see this little marker I'm gonna put on this tree right here. All right, well, it's not much, but I tie this little spot right here. So hopefully they'll see this as an indicator that the trail is this way and that they're still traveling on it. I think there's another tricky spot up here. That's why I got another, I don't know, this is probably like 8 inches. And let's see. Yeah, so like over here, I'm gonna lay like another spot somewhere like on this tree right here. I'll have to find a spot, but the path kind of goes, you can hardly see it. So I'm gonna lay another spot. I mean, look at this. I don't know if you really consider this much of a trail. I mean, especially like right here. You're almost like bushwhacking. I don't know if I'm on the trail or not, but I'm gonna lay a piece right up here because it looks like, I mean, I don't know if this is a trail or not, but I'm assuming that it is. So I'm gonna put a piece right on here. Well, well, well. Look what we got here. Oh, that was almost too fast. We got vehicles. So we made it. And it's 11:20. Not too shabby if you ask me. So, made it. It was another great, wonderful trip. Nice little weekend for it. Getting kind of lucky right now with all this great weather. So I'm just gonna head over to the truck, unload everything, and this is my first time using the Z-Pack Arc Blast Cuban Fiber. Loved it. So I'm gonna have to do maybe like a review on it, and let you know what I think. But thank you for watching, and also, if you like this video, and if you want to see more like it, please like it, subscribe, and I don't know, just glad that you watched it and you enjoyed it. Thanks a lot. Take care.